Good Morning Bay Street is a production of TheUptrend.com and is for information and educational purposes only. The views and opinions expressed in this presentation are those of Stephen Whiteside and should not be considered personal investment advice. Always consult a qualified financial advisor before making any investment decisions. To learn more about the charts featured in this presentation, please visit TheUptrend.com. And now, here is Stephen Whiteside with today's newsletter.
Good morning, Steve Whiteside here with your daily market outlook for Wednesday, December 2nd, 2009. In the pre-market this morning at 7:30 a.m. on the East Coast, we've got futures down slightly across the board. European markets were down. Gold is up in the pre-market on Wednesday. Now, Tuesday's market activity was quite exciting. It's the first day of December, a full moon. December is traditionally a good month for the stock market. But one of the things you need to note is the fact that we really didn't make any new ground yesterday. We're still range bound. This is an hourly chart for the TSX. We ran up to previous resistance. For energy stocks, we ran up to previous resistance. For financial stocks, we're up to 175, stopped at resistance. For the S&P 500 and the NASDAQ, up to previous resistance and stopped. Only gold stocks were able to move above the recent highs and make new ground. For the rest of the market, we're pretty well still range bound. Looking at the hourly charts for Wednesday's trading activity, we can remain bullish as long as we don't close below 11,580 on an hourly basis for the TSX, below 289.50 on the TSX Energy Index, below 173.80 on the TSX Financial Services Index, and 375 on the TSX Gold Index. Gold is up in the pre-market this morning, so we should see some support for gold stocks at the open. Taking a look at our daily charts, we've been following the Bank of Montreal. It moved up to previous resistance yesterday. A daily close below 52.70 on Wednesday would give us a new daily sell signal. Yesterday, we noted the bearish reversal signal that we had on Monday for CIBC. We were looking for fall through to the downside. Now, we didn't get fall through to the downside, but when you consider that the stock market was up nearly 300 points, the TSX was up nearly 300 points, and one of the biggest banks in Canada closes unchanged and made a nice reversal intraday. We moved higher during the day and then came right down and closed near the lows. That's bearish in itself. So we didn't get fall through to the downside, but when you've got a market that's up nearly 300 points and your stock closes unchanged, that's not a bullish signal. So 67.25, that's our breakdown point for CIBC on Wednesday. We've been watching Manulife for looking for a turnaround in the insurance sector. Daily close above 19 would give us a new buy signal. Sun Life is on a buy signal, still treading water here. So absolutely no momentum to the upside for these insurance stocks. 28.60 is our breakdown point for Wednesday for Sun Life. Yamana, our proxy for the gold sector, a daily close below 13.90 on Wednesday would give us a new daily sell signal. Food Fight, lots of movement in grocery store stocks yesterday. 32.10 for Loblaws would give us a new sell signal. For Metro Stores, 35.60. And George Weston, the owner of Loblaws, 59.75 would be our breakdown point on Wednesday for the Westons. Taking a look at Research in Motion, was up nearly 3% yesterday, not enough to give us a buy signal. A daily close above 64 would give us a new buy signal. Looking at our indexes and futures contracts, the only major change yesterday was the drop in natural gas. We're range bounds for the TSX. We've got last week's high, last week's low to break out of. A daily close below 11,447 would give us a new daily sell signal on Wednesday. For the Venture Exchange, and you can't trade the Venture Exchange as an index or really an ETF. We watch this as a proxy, so we don't have to individually look at all the microcap stocks. We assume that when it's in an uptrend as it is now, that most of the microcap stocks are doing fairly well. And when we're in a downtrend, we assume that there's selling in the microcap stocks. So we just use this as a proxy for all those microcap and small cap stocks on the Venture Exchange. We're looking for daily close below 13.95 to give us a new daily sell signal. For gold stocks, we're looking for a daily close below 363.80. For gold itself, it's up in the pre-market on Wednesday. We need a daily close below 11.58. For copper, we're looking for a daily close below 380. Looking at the Canadian dollar, we're still range-bound here. We're down in the pre-market on Wednesday. We're looking for a daily close below 93.95 to give us a new daily sell signal. For the financial stocks, a big turnaround from last week. We need a daily close below 172.25 to give us a new daily sell signal. For energy stocks, close just above the upper channel line. For a new buy signal, we need a daily close below 285 on Wednesday to give us a new daily sell signal. For crude oil, sharp up move yesterday gave us a new daily buy signal. Unfortunately, we're down in the pre-market on Wednesday. New sell signal would be generated on a daily close below 77.25. Natural gas, very disappointing. The blues faded away. Just look across the bottom of the chart. We certainly want to try to go long natural gas anytime we've got blue on the screen, and the blue's starting to fade away, and we now have a new sell signal for natural gas, so that is unfortunate. Okay, that's all for Wednesday morning, folks. Just keep in the back of your mind that we're still range-bound here, and while yesterday's market activity seems positive from a distance, when you look closer, we're still trading in a tight range, and we're looking for a breakout to the upside or a breakdown below last Friday's lows. So have a great day, and we'll talk to you again on Thursday morning.
That was Stephen Whiteside with today's Good Morning Bay Street newsletter. For more information on our charts and services, please visit theuptrend.com.